Do you ever have an event in your past that is essentially dictating your future, right? And what I mean by this is the fact that your past has such a hold on you that you cannot see the future, right? You are so focused on that past event that you are living essentially a life in which you are just completely miserable because of that one mistake, right? Now, my name is Marcus. This is Discover Ignite, where we discover possibilities and ignite change. And today I want to talk about assigning meaning. Now, what do I mean by this? A lot of times when an event happens in your life, you know, we give it a specific kind of meaning, right? Now, a good example this would be in a relationship. Say something doesn't work out for whatever reason, you essentially assign yourself blame, right? You assign yourself some kind of blame, and for every future relationship, you've essentially tainted your relationships because of whatever that happened in that previous relationship, whatever reasoning behind that relationship, if it was the fact that, you know, you guys just didn't mesh well, communication broke down, whatever the case, right? You've essentially identified yourself as something. You've assigned meaning to whatever happened out of that outcome. And in future, essentially, relationships, you fail that if it ever comes around to this point, that this is a weak point in your life. And so ultimately, the thing is here, right? It's not just in relationships, it's everything in life, right? I think it boils down to assigning meaning in anything that is meaningful to you, right? Is something driving your life into essentially the gutter, right? To the point to where you aren't enjoying your life. You're not being happy. You don't have joy. You don't have any of these things because that event that you've assigned meaning to is essentially driving everything. And the best way to try to undo this, the best way to try to understand this is to think of that event, right? How are you feeling, right? Now, there's a lot of times in my past relationships, I felt anger at myself for essentially letting myself down, right? And to reassign that, right? To reassign that meaning, right? I try to look at what the positive outcomes are from that event, right? To reassign meaning is to take that event and essentially dissect it and try to find the pros as opposed to the cons, right? Or the negatives that occurred during that event. And assign better meaning, right? Look for something. If you can't find something, really spend the time, right? Really spend the time on that event and really just pull whatever it is, whatever positives you can. Maybe it can only be one or two things, but really just concentrate on that thing. And the best thing to understand here is to understand that your subconscious, right, is constantly working in the background. So if you take that event and try to bring it to the forefront again and redissect it to the positive aspects of that event, you know, just replay the positive pieces, right? Yeah, there might have been a lot of bad things. Address that. Yes, there are bad things, but I only want to focus on these positive aspects and continue to focus and continue to cycle through these positive thoughts. And you realize that pretty soon that the cycle, it starts reassigning meaning to that event. Now, when you're looking at this event and dissecting it for those positive things, I've found that what the best thing to do is to replay those things in your mind. And you realize that by doing this, that those future events, right, those future relationships or whatever situation you are talking about or you're trying to dissect, that you'll realize that you have a little bit more positivity in it, right? Because you realize what your strengths are and you soon build up those weaknesses, right? Because you're not allowing those weaknesses to actually pull you down. You're actually allowing those positive thoughts and those ideas that you've been replaying in your mind, you bring those to the forefront. And so every new relationship and every new situation that you're challenging yourself and realizing that you aren't these negative things because you've essentially reassigned meaning to something more positive, right? And allowed yourself to essentially drive yourself, right? And then you don't look at those weaknesses as such a bad thing because you have all those other positive things. And you realize that you can actually apply this to anything in life. And by doing this, you realize that you become, you know, more energetic. You realize that you become a much happier person. You are more fulfilled because of the fact that you aren't looking at things in such a negative light. And by assigning meaning to those things that are holding you back, you realize that you are actually moving forward in your life, that you're moving towards the right direction that you want to be in, right? And not living in the past anymore, or so fixated on bad traits about whatever you may have, right? That can be fixed, right? That can be overlooked if you can kind of concentrate and reassign that meaning to a more positive state of mind that will allow you to pull yourself out of whatever rut you are and stop you from living again in the past. So by assigning meaning, you have to really go through those things that are ultimately holding you back, right? And whatever you feel that aspect of your life is, I gave the example of relationships, but this can go through anything, right? This can go through work, through business, you know, whatever you're trying to do, whatever you feel like, man, I'm really bad at that, right? Why don't you reassign meaning, right? What am I really good at? And you focus on that, and you realize that by playing this loop back and those things that you tend to focus on, your mind starts thinking more of that thing, those positive things, where if you are repeating that cycle of those bad things, right, you are essentially assigning meaning that that's what you are, right? But if you keep it positive, then that positive loop, that positive feedback is ultimately what's going to get that mindset changed, what's ultimately going to push you forward, it's ultimately going to motivate you to make dramatic good changes in your life, because you realize that, hey, I've reassigned meaning. I'm not such a bad person that I thought I was, right? I'm actually pretty good, and I'm pretty good at these specific things because I've been playing those things back in my mind to allow myself to move forward, to take advantage of the situations I'm in, to be my best when it comes to relationships, right? Because I know what my strengths are and my weaknesses. Yes, when I address my weaknesses, I work on those weaknesses, but ultimately I know what my strengths are. I know the positive aspects that I'm looking at, that I'm repeating in my head, and that in itself, right, just changing that mindset could ultimately just benefit you in the whole. Because your mood, your energy, everything just dramatically changes by just reassigning that meaning. And you realize that life gets a whole lot better. So if you enjoyed this video, remember to hit the like button on the way out. Till next time, I will see you guys later.